Here is what you will learn in this video. You will learn how to scrape 1,000 lines. You will learn how to scrape 1,000 jobs on LinkedIn. And the best thing about that is that you can do it for free with Octoparse. You can download it by clicking on the link just below. The first thing we need to do is to make our research. So we simply go to linkedin.com. And as we have said, we are looking to apply for jobs. So I click on jobs. And I want to be, for instance, an accountant in New York City. So here is a page I want to scrape. I simply need to copy and paste the URL in Octoparse. Here is the home page. I paste the URL and I click on start. And here is a tricky thing about this website. I think you agree with me. Our purpose is to load as many reviews as possible. And in order to do so, we simply need to scroll down the page. And it works. So we scroll down the page again and again. But after we scroll down the page 6 times, there is a See More Jobs button. And it's actually really clever because it means it couples a scroll down technique and a show more button technique. And Octoparse could deal with it. We will see how to do it in a minute. To do so, we first need to tell Octoparse, scroll down the page 6 times. So I click on the action settings after loading page and scroll down the page after it's loaded. Then I repeat the process 6 times and I set up a waiting time of, let's say, 5 seconds, and I click on OK. Once it is done, we can already scrape some information. And it won't be that difficult because we only need to click on the blue button and auto-detect web page data. And what it will do is that it will scrape the page automatically. I simply wait a little bit and here it is. I uncheck add a page scroll because remember we already tell Octoparse to scroll down the page 6 times, and I click create workflow. And that is pretty good. I simply need to clean my file a little bit. So I click on action settings. Here is the title. That's great. Here is the URL. So I type URL. I delete this piece of information. This one is the company name. So I type company. Here is the city, the location, and I delete the label. I don't think that's useful, and the date is useful, so I keep it. And I click on OK to save the change. We are pretty good for now, but this is not over yet. I think you remember what we have said earlier, but it's time to click on the Show More button. I scroll down to the bottom of the page, and here is a See More Jobs button. Then I click on the blue button, Load More button, I click on it, and I click on Confirm. And I will set up an Ajax timeout of 10 seconds. Okay, now you've got 2 options. If you already have all the information you have been looking for, you can stop here. You simply need to save your task and to run your task, and you will get results. But if you want to get additional information, such as the job description or other detailed information, we need to click on each job link. How to do that? We click on the blue button once again and click on links to scrape the linked page. Then I select the URL and I click on confirm. Wait a little bit, and as you can see, we have now access to the detailed page. Before we move on, I want to give you a piece of advice. Because look, it's possible that LinkedIn randomly shows 2 different layouts. And why should you matter? Because if you've got the same layout as mine, which means you've got the job list and the description on a different page, you should make sure that if you click on the action settings, you check open in a new tab. But if you've got another layout in which you've got both the job list and the description on the same page, you should rather uncheck open in a new tab and check load with Ajax. And you can set up an Ajax timeout of 7 seconds that should work, and you click on OK. And now we can select other information. For instance, the job description. I click on the description and extract the text of the selected element. And here is the entire description. That's not all. I could select the seniority level, the employment type, the job function, and the industry. And here it is. If you follow all these steps, we should be good. Now our task is over. We need to save what we have done and to run our task. And same thing as usual, if you are a premium user of Octoparse, we can click Run in the Cloud, otherwise, run on your device works fine. A few moments later, it is done. We just need to export data, for instance, in an Excel format. So I click on OK. If we take a look, we see that we've got pretty much all the information we have been looking for. Hope my video got your confusion cleared away. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos regarding Octoparse and web scraping. We will always keep you updated.